Hey, my name is Jimmy Raven. I'm the Fortify Product Manager, and I'm here today to show the new Fortify Jenkins plugin and specifically highlight the new native pipeline support that we've added. If you go to Jenkins and manage Jenkins and manage plugins, you'll be able to search for the word Fortify on the available tab. So simply type Fortify here, and if you don't already have it installed, it will show up and allow you to install it directly from the marketplace. All the code is open sourced and hosted in GitHub now, and it is distributed exclusively through the Jenkins marketplace. Once it is installed, you will come here and you'll see the Fortify plugin has been installed and the specific version that we've installed here. Once it's installed, we just have a couple basic configuration steps. So if we go to Manage Jenkins and Configure System, you will see I've created a Fortify home environment variable to tell Jenkins where Fortify is installed. That's the static code analyzer product that's going to run the scan. And in at the bottom here, you'll see Fortify assessment. We need to tell it where Software Security Center's URL is, where are we going to be uploading the result file, if we're going to be doing build failure, where is that information coming from. This is the token that you create in Software Security Center. You can do that by coming to Administration, Users, and Token. And if you click New, you'll see we have a Jenkins token type. You can select, right? And if you do that, you will get a copy of your decoded token value that you can use with the Jenkins plugin. Do take note of this, it's only presented to you one time, though it is easy to delete or create a new token if you need to. So if we go back to Jenkins, once that's set, you can click Advanced and Test Connection. See that the connection is successful. We are using the default issue template, the prioritized high risk. That is the default template that most of you are familiar with. But you can use any custom template if you'd like. And if we go back, let's go back to our main dashboard in Jenkins and look at a sample project that I've configured. So if we look here, here's our pipeline script, and here are specific Fortify tasks. So how did I know how to write these specifically? I used the pipeline syntax generator. I can choose any of the Fortify steps: clean, scan, translate, update, or upload. All of them have input boxes to select your options, and then when we click generate code, it will generate the appropriate code that we need to paste in to the syntax file. So if we were to look at one of these tasks, we could put in our test, our application version, the name of our result file, right? Anything that we wanted to do in terms of build failure, if we wanted to say something like, category, is path manipulation, right? And this works with anything in the SSC search criteria. So you'll see here, you can go to SSC, and basically if you can search for it in an application version, then you can paste that search value here, and that will query the result endpoint and see if that issue is present and therefore fail the build. So once you've done that, you can say generate pipeline script, and there you go. That's what you need for Fortify upload. And you can do the same thing for the other steps. So if we're going to go back to our test project, you'll see that I've done my clean, my update of the rule packs, the translation options to turn the code into intermediate files, the scan options, and the upload options, including that I want to fail this build if any path manipulation vulnerabilities are present. We also can select the polling interval. I chose 1 minute. That can be adjusted depending on how large these artifacts are in terms of how long it takes SSC to process. If we go ahead and let's take a look at kicking this project off. So if we go ahead and build now, we'll take a quick look at the console output. And we will grab that right here. Okay, so we've done our clean step, we've done our updating step, we've done our translation step, and now we're running our scan step. Once that finishes, it will upload the results to Software Security Center, and then it will wait 1 minute before searching for the existence of those issues. This will take about 2 minutes to finish, but if we want, we can go ahead and come in here, and if we look at the build history, we will be able to see that these builds were marked as unstable due to console output. And then if you look at the console output of those previous builds, you'll see the existence of path manipulation. If we are to go back to our current build, you can see that the FPR has been uploaded successfully, meaning that we can come into SSC, we can take a look at our test project here, and look at any artifacts, and you can see that we have completed this scan right here. Oh, I'm sorry, this is the wrong app real quick. Sorry, clicked on the wrong one. There we go. So if we go to artifacts, we'll see that SCA scan was completed successfully. This is our current timestamp. Jenkins is just waiting to process the issue and then run the search query for you, and then mark the build as unstable if that condition is actually met. So everything that we've done, upload, clean, translate, all is done through the pipeline syntax. So you can see here it's retrieving the build statistics for SSC. In just a second, we will have the conclusion of our build, which will let us know that there are a few issues in the path manipulation category that we wanted to mark the build as unstable. So here we go, we're about to process and finish that. And you can see here that this build has four vulnerabilities that have met the build condition and the build is marked as unstable. If a developer wants to view the issues in Jenkins, they can come in here to Fortify Assessment. This uses our API to display deep links to those issues. So they can go through and click on the high categories and you'll see the particular issues in question. Those are deep links that you can use to click into SSC, or you could just browse to SSC manually. Hopefully that is helpful while you're setting up the new Fortify Jenkins plugin, specifically with your pipeline builds. Thank you very much.